in order to explain the emission of light from atom, it was assumed that whenever an atom receives energy from outside, the electrons in it start vibrating and radiate light waves of the frequency of their vibration. But according to this explanation, there should be only one line in the spectrum of hydrogen atom, which has only one electron, whereas in fact it has many lines. Thus, this model could not explain the spectrum. Second, this model could not predict any region for alpha particle scattering, which was demonstrated experimentally by Rutherford. Hence, this model could not be accepted. Now let's see Rutherford's experiment of scattering of alpha particles. To determine the true structure of atom, Rutherford performed an important experiment shown in figure. In it, a fine beam of high energy alpha particles emitted by a radioactive material, polonium, was made to fall on a very thin gold foil. A thin gold foil was taken to ensure that alpha particle was deflected by a single collision. Gold foil was taken because gold can be beaten into a very thin foil, and secondly, gold nucleus being very heavy produces a large deflection in alpha particles. The whole arrangement was kept in vacuum so that there were no collisions of alpha particles with air molecules. Rutherford observed that on passing through the gold foil, the particles are deflected in different directions. This phenomenon of deflection of alpha particles from their path is called scattering. The particles emerging from the gold foil in different directions can be counted by a scintillation counter. Rutherford inferred the following important facts from this experiment. First, most of the alpha particles pass straightway through the gold foil without being affected in any way. From this, Rutherford concluded that atom is mostly hollow inside. In no case it can be solid, as was assumed by Thomson. Second, some alpha particles are deflected at small angles and their angular distribution is definite. Now, since alpha particles are positively charged, the part of the atom deflecting them must also be positive. On this basis, Rutherford concluded that the whole of the positive charge of atom must be concentrated in a very small space. It cannot be distributed uniformly inside the atom, as was assumed by Thomson. Third, a few of the alpha particles are scattered at angles greater than 90 degree from their initial path and return back as shown in figure. From this it is evident that when high speed positively charged alpha particles pass through the atoms of the gold foil, then a few of them experience such a strong repulsive force so as to return back. On this basis, Rutherford assumed that the positive charge in the atom is concentrated in an extremely small space at the center of the atom. This space is called the nucleus. Calculations show that the radius of the nucleus is of the order of 10 power minus 14 meter, while the radius of the atom is of the order of 10 power minus 10 meter. Thus, the radius of the nucleus is only a 10,000 part of the radius of the atom. In the rest of the empty space of the atom around the nucleus,